Down. This is Melissa Armo with the Stock Swoosh, and here I'm taking a look at the market. This is the QQQs. It was a nice long today. Didn't have the big lift that, you know, the market's had some of the days in here, but considering the fact it's the summer, you know, it's the middle of the week, there wasn't any huge earnings out or news or economic data out today, and the market held. And, you know, I got to be honest with you, I mean, my bias in this market now is very, very different than it looked several months ago. You know, and there's still many issues hanging out there as far as news goes and world events and things that are happening all across the world, particularly in reference to the tariffs. And, you know, that could actually have an effect on the market. But all in all, the market made it through earnings season, and a lot of the big names, a lot of the big companies reported extremely well for earnings, and the market held up. And it's held up, and it's held up here through this summer. And I'm just looking at the Qs, but the SPY, I feel the same way. So the Qs have been pushing forward faster than the S&P, and the reason is because of Apple, Amazon. Okay, you know, these are the leading stocks that are in charge, and they're moving it forward. Apple made a brand new all-time high just yesterday. So you had the Qs falling yesterday, even though they gapped up, had the rally, but recovered today, gapped up today, and this was a nice long. It was a late long. It was a late long. You could have just bought the market. I'm just going to go over this in here, right in here, and then poof, you could have just taken it right up. Pretty much into 12 o'clock, noon, 12:15-ish, you could have got in, out, in, out. I wouldn't say this was a quick trade. Quick trades for us are 5 minutes, 2 minutes, 3 minutes, 1 minute, 10 minutes. This, you did have to wait in this trade and sit in this trade for about an hour and a half, hour and 45 minutes, depending on where you exited it. But the fact is that it worked. Some days you need to get something, you want to get something, there isn't much to do. You can sit and wait around, or you can walk away. This did work. I would be shocked, really shocked if the market didn't hold here tomorrow. So my call for the market tomorrow is we gap up or we open neutral and rally, or a slight gap down and rally. Unless we gap down something huge tomorrow, this market will hold. So we look for follow through and continuation and possibly a new high in the market tomorrow and Wednesday for no reason. No reason whatsoever at all, just because the market's getting bought. So we closed today around 181.60. High in here is almost 183. That's $1.40 away. That's totally, totally doable. And I'm not saying we definitely do it, but it's in sight. So I would be shocked if the market did not follow through higher tomorrow. If we don't, it could be an inside range day, and then we follow through later on the week, Wednesday, Thursday, Friday. Three more days this week. It looks like the market's going to close out strong for August. Unless something disastrous happens, I don't see us not closing strong for this month, in the summer, in the QQQs. Again, a lot of it has to do with Apple and the strength that happened on the earnings that reported a few weeks ago in that stock, which plays a big portion of this Qs, which is kind of weird. I mean, it really shouldn't be like that, but the fact is it is. So you got to take it into account. If you're in this, if you did it today, it was a good, solid long. If you're in it as an option, a cause as an option, you can stick with it, even though the fast exit was yesterday. This could continue. So good luck, everyone. We'll see what happens tomorrow in this and the other earnings that are coming out between now and the end of the week. A couple big names coming out this week, mostly retailers, and, you know, they could affect the market, positive or negative. We don't know. Good luck, everyone.